Top of the afternoon, depending on where you are, I have no idea. But I know where this thing is, and this thing's sitting on my bench. This has been here before, and the last time I serviced this, I let the owner know that at some point in the future, one of the 7-pin sockets would require a replacement. And so we just decided to push that off for the future, and the future is now. So it's back in my custody for a bit. And if you don't know anything about these amps, this is just, in my opinion, tone-wise, a pumped-up champ with a 12, with the perfect size cabinet. It's lightweight. The construction is a little shoddy on these because they were just meant to be like a throw around bass combo, a little cheap bass combo. But man, you want to talk about a great guitar amp for overdriven tones. This is my favorite. This is absolutely my favorite non-reverb Fender for guitar. And it's not even a close second. And super tough to get with the original knobs. Like, good luck. So there's a few different versions of these. Some of them have the AC or mains power switch on the little slider that you would find on the 60s and 70s Fenders, labeled as a bright switch. Some folks think that they're not really up to the job, but you know, these are not powerful amps. Wow, that switch doesn't really have to do much, and they typically last a long time as is. I mean, if you look there, it actually says stamped in the metal there on the bracket, you know, 120 volts, 125 or whatever it is. So it can do it, but these are the coolest. I like these the best. This amp was one of the best examples that I've heard. This and one of my buddy Randy's, he has one, and those two are probably about neck and neck. A little different, but still up there. I love it. So let me turn her around for you guys so you can take a peek for yourself. So obviously this is not the stock speaker. But man, I'm glad it's not. This thing sounds tremendous in here. This is a beautiful sounding speaker in this amp. The power section, probably around, you know, 14, 18 watts, courtesy of 2 6 AQ5s. Let me bring the old crappy lamp over. Yeah, 6 AQ5s. Old Sylvania stock here. And 112 AX7 preamp tube with a solid state rectifier. And then the old, you can kind of see some of the old Silverface heritage in the baffle, the speaker baffle, which looks like it's particle. But this amp was early enough where it has some of that, the blackface construction cues here. So you can kind of see that, right? So this is probably one of the more desirable ones that you can get. Love it. Absolutely love these. They don't come with fuses. So I added this fuse here. They don't come with a lot of things that we kind of take for granted, and I add them. So this one in particular, I'll be investigating some of the intermittent signal issues. And I think, just going through my records, I had made a note about the socket. So while I was out there, let me take a quick peek here. I just remember, 7-pin. So I'm trying to find a box for these. I'll just drop them right here. While I was sourcing parts for these, wouldn't look at that. Yeah, poor guy. I have something that may or may not straighten these. While I was sourcing parts, I had run across a good deal on some 7-pin sockets, so I just scooped them up. And these are much nicer than the ones that run stock. And I love these. So these should drop right in, but these are much nicer than the ones that Fender had chosen to use. And literally, they used the cheapest parts they could possibly use on these. In fact, it almost looked like they went out of their way, like it was some inside joke, you know, with the accountants. On the inside, the amp is incredibly haphazardly constructed. It kind of matches the exterior. And there are a lot of gains to be made with these amps with respect to tone stack mods, with respect to gain staging, with respect to the actual lead dress. Because some of these are constructed on eyelet boards and some of them are constructed with a turret strip that runs right down, that runs actually lengthwise down the amp, transverse down the chassis, I should say. And on those, if you'll look at where the where like the noisy wires and the AC supply are running, you'll see that, wow, that's why this is noisy. And it doesn't take a whole lot of work to reduce the background noise in these, but it's well worth spending, you know, an extra hour or so just to tidy it up for your customer. So I'll get this thing cracked open and I'll whip up another video for you guys. And a lot of you guys have ruined the secrets out, you know, on these amps. You used to be able to pick these things up for like $200. You know, but some asshole decided to plug his guitar into one and then start bragging about it. Now, if you see one of these beat up for $600, you're lucky. Used to be one of the best kept secrets out there, but not anymore. So, hope this finds you well. Take care. Bye-bye.